Amica Plus, my name is Max Waldo, and you are watching Maryland Bobcats play Albion San Diego. Welcome on board, we're happy you joined us for tonight's matchup, a critical contest here as the NISA season draws to a close later on this month. It is finally October, the air is starting to get chilly in the night here in Maryland as we get set for this freezing cold matchup. Tonight's matchup between the 4th place Bobcats and the 2nd place and the 3rd place Albion San Diego features two teams that are in interesting spots in their season. Albion San Diego on their Eastern road trip, taking care of this matchup tonight. And over the weekend, they will play Flower City Union. For Maryland, it is their final homestand as they play here tonight in San Diego and next Saturday against Gold Star FC to wrap up the home half of their season. As the teams get set for their match day pictures, we'll get started with the starting lineup. First for the visitors, from California coach by Diego Lopez. Benjamin Roach will be in the net for... We'll get the whistle from Valverde, Guerrero Garcia, our match official, and we are underway. Back to Roach for the first touch, and this one is sent into the blender on the near side of the field. Not 100% sure what San Diego is doing on this formation, but they've got a bunch of guys surrounding Espinosa trying to break through. Guys, I think that might have been offside here, so San Diego will let the ball run out of play. That is Almeida letting that one escort to the touchdown. So here comes Chris Mitchell to get things started with the throw. First minute of action, here's the Marine Hendricks field. Along the right side, this is going to be an interesting strategy for San Diego. They try to push the right side of their attack and the left side of the Bobcats defense as Pierre Richard is sliding into the starting lineup for Maryland. That was not the name I said earlier, so I'm going to have to see who came out instead. Richard was listed as a substitute on the team sheet, but I got an hour ahead of the contest as the ball was out of play for San Diego throw. So, not 100% sure who came out instead. Guevara gets play restarted, the captain for San Diego. You may recognize the last name of Tyler Guevara. He has a rather famous mother, if you must know, one of the originals of the U.S. Women's National Team. Karen Jennings Guevara, who won the Gold Women's World Cup in 1991 and retired as an international player with a gold medal to her name, coming on as the final substitute of the United States in that match against China in the gold medal round. Men in blue push the ball into the midfield area. Maybe it is Ronaldo Pineda. He finds Tyler Guevara. This one will poke all the way through, and Alex Sutton will calm things down for his defense. Gotta get ready for anything to be different here as Darwin Espinal knifes through three players and then is fouled along the way. So the ball will have to come back to the spot of foul, but the ball was kicked away toward Alex Sutton, so instead you'll need a little bit of help to get that ball to its intended spot. Cyrus Tran is standing over the spot where the foul occurred. Cyrus gets this going again. Violet hooks a three, Espinal's got. Looking for his one-time quick signal, 6 minutes of this pass goes away. Just grab! Mitchell gets a California knows is listed hometown. One of the few players on the team that has started, both years starting with 19 as opposed to 20. Here's Roach, one of the contenders for Golden Gloves Award. Put the pass ahead for Corey, and Lordina jumps over a pass, jumps over. direction.
Back on Houston.
subs plus maybe a goalie. San Diego does have in the full recovery of Buckingham, but the only defender listed on the bench today is Gustavo Andrade Ibarra. So Mitchell, and he played his college ball every day. They're in currently 5 or 6 in sixth spot right now. Mitchell is off. He's being waved on. So he's at least fit enough to continue the contest for now as Baylor gets ready to start. Gonzalez didn't really have enough to play forward. Philip Brown's got it. Over to Josiah Busata. Switches frame of attack for Gonzalez. Looking for Burnett. Burnett tips off of a San Diego squad player. Burnett has it on his feet, going after it now. Heavy touch. This one is tipped up. Ben Roach jumps and makes the save. With a win tonight, Maryland Bobcats can move to third on a goal differential. They will need help from Gold Star against Los Angeles and the aforementioned Flowers in the Union against San Diego to stay up in the standings. Club de Leon also has play 3 matches in 7 days. All chance on a free kick here. There are 4 men inside the 18-yard box for San Diego on this formation. Maryland has pretty much everybody back in defense. So San Diego's got a couple of direct options chipping into the box. They have a few options outside the box. Interesting spot here for the visitors. Javier Cabrera Garcia has given his final instructions. And we'll restart play with the whistle. Here comes a shot right in the side. He's able to come out. Gets his side fast. Go for Filer. Filer shoots it right in the Wildcats a much improved squad from last season with 2 extra victories to their names so far compared to last year's numbers. Though, they still might finish in fifth this season, just like they did last year. If they do finish in fifth, it is almost impossible for the team to schedule a home playoff game. However, when the Bobcats win out, it's definitely possible for them to get through and host home playoff games. Gonzalez, finding Grant already in the referee's work thanks to a yellow card on the tackle that allowed San Diego to have their most recent free kick chance. Slides it in for the shot. He's offside, he's wiped out of the box on the tackle on the shot. Has plate. We thank you again for joining us here on FIFA Plus. On behalf of all of us here at the Maryland Bobcats, we thank you for making time for us here on this Wednesday night. I understand that many of you are working and have things that you have to get done 9 to 5, so it's amazing there's a bit of a lighter crowd here tonight in Hendricks Field compared to our weekend attendance numbers, as is to be expected for a with midday matches. Cross for Mitchell. Pass was a little bit weak, but Mitchell is the one who got to it first. For Cardona. Cardona one-on-one with Fireman. He's repelled back. That's for what Dean couldn't get there. Espinal. Locked down off Mitchell. That was a little bit. And Alex Sutton's got it as Maryland resets their attack, trying the right side of it for me. This one's caught off Alexander Bellew, coming off the pass to Philip Burnett, moving now into the penalty area. Everyone keeping their arms down. Lundin, one touch here, looking for Sutton. Sutton with a massive dive and a massive save. Well, the Pineda could not get through. Uncharacteristic of one of Sutton's passes to go missing. It's intended target. That one did. And a nice pickoff from Alexander Bellew nearly cost the Bobcats. Getting a clearance up the middle. Another shot. Can I hit it up? Finally. And again on the opposite side. Gonzalez lets it go by him. All the way for Burnett. Gonzalez, a little bit of room up front. And find it for Espinal. Dangerous than it might have seen on TV. So two yellow cards in that sequence, Ronaldo Pineda for Albion and Alex Sutton for Maryland. I believe the free kick is still going to be awarded for Maryland as Sutton's yellow card came after the play was considered to be over. Albion's foul was during the play. So Sutton's going to be the one to take it, as he sometimes does when there's a free kick on this part of the defensive line. which side's the man? Another pass cut off by Pineda. And Shaw.
Thank you.
Filer. Too young. Used to play the NHL, but soon there was a season well taken away by the game. Tonight, Ben Roach is not going to have an even 0-0 draw with the question is now, is Maryland's offense going to be able to break through this Albion defense sometime in this contest? Takes the restart kick. So two members of the Maryland backline are on yellow card. This pass cuts through. We're going to get up into the box and Sutton stops the pass here again. Alexander Dalou is coming across the formation. Sutton sending the long pass. members of the right side defense for Maryland have run their coverage this morning. Drew Young, looking for a lane to pass the ball through, finds it up top. Espinal got ahead to it, and Roach makes the save on a bouncing ball. This first half is going to be over. Tran hooks the header up. This time Sutton gets his gloves on it again. Finally, the field keeps on the ground for Gonzalez. Gonzalez has control. He's trying to really crush it. On the nose, had a little bit of room as it turned away. Ernest Mitchell with a header. It's a nice pass. It sends out the substitution here. As this one bounces off of a San Diego player and is going to be kicked to the touchline for a throw-in in the offensive third. Maryland's getting 1-0 off the goal by Cyrus Tran, who got the rebound off of a shot off the crossbar. Where he finds Michael Cornet, who sends a back pass. This clearance made his chunk to kick it very far. 5 minutes into the middle of the box is awry. Here's Daniel Akintoye. Riddle has some space, cuts to the middle of the field, loses that space, and goes back for Daniel. Corey will now go back and throw it around, playing on the yellow card so far in this cover test. For Alex Sutton, who is also playing on the yellow card. The man I'm pointing replaces is Philip Burnett, who was playing on a yellow card. You may have noticed this is a theme here for Maryland. Ernest Mitchell can't handle this ball. Balls for Espinal, who pokes it inside. A two-yellow swing and a miss. Gonzalez cuts in. He's going to win the ball, surrounded by two San Diego players. bounces off a defender and falls at feet for the visitors from California. The foul was called here on Daniel Akinkori. Was trying to break free. No card is issued for the sub. So we're going to keep going. This has been an aggressive contest here for both squads. Roach, looking for Dalu. Get passed away. joking about this name, Middelfart, in Denmark for the 2018 season of the Danish second division. You can look it up yourself. M-I-D-D-E-L-F-A-R-T is the name of the team. I swear, they're a Danish team, they are real, and Ryan Buckingham did play for them. Waiting the entire night to make that note. I finally have a reason to do so. Offside on the Bobcats. As we now get back to live action. Ernest Mitchell, the other one to restart the clock. Back for Ben Roach, who is working on yet another one of his shutouts. He's got 11 so far.
Yes, Eddie!
Well done to win the header. He poked it out of play, but it kept the ball away from Alexander Fleet. Or early October day in Maryland so far. Player. Stands over. Team's leading goal scorer, Lyons, fires, and it is off the crossbar and out. Rebound. And two. A golden opportunity for the Wildcats, and the player is down inside the box. That's Philip Brown. Alex Sutton has turns up into the center. chance for somebody to attend to Philip Brown. He's getting a chance to look at a delayed feed. Brown, he's back in the center of the spot. Maryland does have one defender on the list of the roster today. It's Della Mansour. Four substitutes. Ball is dropped from the bar to restart play. Back for Canada. Lagoya. Wind and send it. Pass for Pierre Richard. He can't keep control. He played 63-4 minutes here for the Maryland Soccer Classic at Andrews Field. Send the center backs forward and out to the long line. Patton Moore, the keeper, sending it long into the narrow night. But now we have a player, so he plays it in his hands. Rashawn. Midfield circle, chips it in. Cooper acting for A. Michael, that is, running into Ernest Mitchell. Mitchell's pass for Filer. Espen, Filer. Runners coming in, pass is intercepted. Oh, you have a chance to break, but it's pass is errant. Colt Brown has it back for side. Doya forces the pass. Daniel acting for A, gets away from Archer. Contact was made by Alexander Bali making a tackle. Head on the corner to his credit, kept his balance. But still, a foul was awarded in favor of the Bobcats. Back and forth. He's got some space down the right side. Space is closed off. Riggle runs the touchline, looking back for his brother Daniel. Daniel sends a pass out. Throwing for the visitors in blue. Looks like you may be able to see on your screen in the bottom right corner a sub. He's getting ready to come in from Maryland. We'll tell you about that. He finally lights up the fourth official's table. Michael Akinkoye may have gotten a little foul on that one. Daniel Akinkoye is up for the field line. It looks like it's the lead time. There's 7 in the lead and set to come here. Trailed by one. Into the final 35 minutes of this contest. I'll stop the time when I have a bunch of Gonzalez, wind it up and go. Daniel Akinkoye gets on the air. He can pass on this rainbow. He's shoved at the bounds. The ball runs out of play. Not going to call a foul. They're just going to go throw it to San Diego. Pineda. Barra. Back for Pineda. Anna sends it long, but sends it kind of low. And then Chesta Dalou, headed down for Riggle, finds Gonzalez, who finds Abdullah. Now he's taking the ground. Foul here, and a free kick in a closer spot than where that's what I'll try for the net at last time.
Okay, now, do it now, it's okay.
Malik Tom is going to come on for Andrew Riggle. See if I Espinel tries it long to direct toward goal again. Philip Brown came very close to burying the rebound off the crossbar. Espinel gets his signal. Wind up. Go for goal. Right into the waiting arms of Ben Roach. Roach once again looking for his 12th clean sheet of the season. He's got 11 so far. Golden Gloves. What's up? Dahoud. Brandon Yellow Card. Junior Cadono is the one who's come off number 11 in favor of Yuki Shibata. So Shibata, last time the Bobcats fans saw Yuki Shibata, he was a second half substitute for Club de Leon on July 1st when the visitors pulled off a major upset against the Marlin. That turned out to be the last game Shibata played for Club de Leon. Paul comes in with a team to get out here. Philip Brown clears the game. Everybody was sharp. Chest of Ben Roach. flat. As a result of the spot of the foul being all the way back there, San Diego actually loses traction on the field, going from their offensive third back to their defensive third to restart play. That's the sort of time where referee really should play advantage, because the play is already way up ahead. Finally, gets the ball first. Ball's eventually for the Goya. Scoring chance of anybody since the Philip Brown chance earlier this half. For sure. Brown. Brown finding Gonzalez again. Gonzalez finds Michael Akinkoye. Akinkoye cutting free. Michael Akinkoye tries a chance and slides into the arms of Ben Roach. Akinkoye went to ground, appeals for a foul for Maryland's bench, go nowhere. Chips it in. Into the box goes Philo. Philo keeping his balance. Now Espinal. Espinal cuts to his left foot. Cuts him to 6 yards. He cannot get there in time. It's taken out for a throw-in for Maryland. 79th minute of action. Can Maryland find an equalizer? Looking for Gonzalez. Manuel Gonzalez cuts in. He's got the ball. Gets around a couple of defenders. The pass is taken away. And cleared out by Luis Almeida. Siam lets it fall for his feet, keeping it inside the touchline. Gonzalez for Siam. Siam, and the space goes down, giving it to Daniel Akinkoye. Daniel ahead, Malik Tom to the corner flat. Tom puts it back into the middle of the field, lost control of the ball to Kabaras. Kabaras slides past three. Jumps into Malik Tom's body. Malik Tom keeps it in the field flat. For Michael Akinkoye, spinning to the inside. Well, good way to show. taking the points from Albion San Diego will at least get them separation from Michigan tonight. Michigan on their own longest restarted matchups against Buffalo Leon. Or what's left of the team. We have to bounce off the ball. Yeah, the referee's got to stop play at that point. So he'll drop it for Daniel Bedoya. Surrounded by the release ball. Two players look like they're coming on from Maryland. One of them looks like it's Caleb Pritchett. This looks like an all-in type of move. Trying to get a last minute ball. Coming out. Do not stop those guys. Tom. Send me pass. Close wide. Looking for a file. That's Espen. All file. File was playoff. Rashard comes in, takes away from the middle center. Hussain from Abdulyam. Hussain again finds Abdulyam. Back from Daniel Gonzalez. Gonzalez trying for goal, and he sends it on the grass.
Now.
It was going to call for two substitutes to come in. Fireman comes off. Second half sub. Not even brought up. Unusual move for Maryland, but they do need goals. So brought on that sword. The only defender on roster tonight, not to have a goal. He does lead the team total yellow cards for the season. Fire is down. Aforementioned injured player has now rolled to the touchline. Albion's temporarily playing down to 10. A swing and a miss from Abdulyam. Caleb Pritchett moves in. Espinal's got it, moves it into the box.
Go!
Player with sharp hands enough right into the leaning arms of Ben Roach. Feels the pop fly well. We enter the final 5 minutes of regular time here for Marine Hendricks Field. San Diego would likely like a second goal to push themselves further into the goal differential race. Maryland, the main equalizer before they can dream about 3 points. Foul here in San Diego. Gonzalez winds up. Use it for the man who was fouled. Michael Akinkoye.
Just saying.
Balanzor finds Philip Brown. Sutton is way out from his goalkeeper area. Into the box, looking for Pritchett's tall head. And he takes out Ben Roach, and that's going to be a foul on the answer. He is scorer from Community College of Baltimore County, Heatonsville. Essex. Again, looking for his first goal of the NISA season and has been unable to find it. Brown sending it off. Heavy touch. through these next three contests to end the season and have a chance for a home playoff. Maryland, just like all the other teams in ESA, are not invincible at home. It's definitely easier to negotiate travel time and schedules if your team is already in the area. Regular time. And so, back for Sun. Sun, one up with it. That's a running kick for Pritchett. Touch to it and sends it into the body of Luis Almeida. Sun gets by Gonzalez. Brown sends it through. Looking for Sun. Gonzalez, this one bounced off of a sliding Shibata. Goes from the leap top. Top cuts the middle of the field. By blocking Koya. Darwin Espinal.
Go, Bobcat.
Has the ball taken away from him. Final minute of regular time is 7-1. Not sure how much time is going to be added by the got the win, and they've got all 3 points back so far. And Maryland snatch away 2 points and get one of their everything down. semi-wall. Couldn't find solid progress with Pritchett running fast after the ball, looking around Siegel, to the youngest player in the league.